Hi, I'm Rachel from Little Vintage Photography. I use non-digital cameras, which are these kind of old vintage ones that take rolls of film or cartridges of film, a little bit like this. And the idea is that once you've actually shot the roll of film, you process it in special chemistry, and that reveals the final negative that you can then work from. It's quite a magical experience. This is what a negative looks like, or it's a roll of film as negative strips. These ones are from the medium format cameras, so they're sort of like a square shape or a rectangular shape like this, but quite a bit bigger. And these ones here are the 35mm ones. So they have something called sprocket holes at the top and bottom. And if you look at the cartridge of film, you'll see that there is also sprocket holes on that too. That helps it to go through the camera and to make sure that it's actually winding on from frame to frame. So these are individual frames here. So this is a strip of negatives from the whole roll of a 35mm film, and this is a whole roll of medium format film. When you have a final strip of negatives, like something like this, what you can do is actually take the negatives and put them into something called an enlarger. That's in a place called a dark room. It's literally a dark room where you block out the rest of the light. And you might have seen it on TV programs and things where you switch on a red light. What you would do is to put one of your negatives into an enlarger. You'd shine light through the negative onto photographic paper. The photographic paper has a coating on it, which is a chemical that has a reaction with that light. And then you put it through some more chemistry to develop, stop and fix it. And you're left with a final print at the end. Once you have your set of negatives, the other thing you might want to do is create a contact sheet. As a film photographer myself, these are something that I use all the time. I'll show you what I mean here. Now, I've got a contact sheet of 35mm negatives and a contact sheet of the medium format negatives. There we go. And what you would do is you basically lay your negatives onto photographic paper, you shine light from an enlarger onto it, and then you process these in developer, stop and fix, and you're left with the final positive impression of your negative strips. They're a really useful tool because it means that you can actually decide and look at the images before you choose to print them up in the same way as we might do with digital files, rather than actually editing every single frame or every single image. Using a contact sheet gives you the opportunity to actually choose which ones are your favourites and which ones you would actually like to print up, rather than having to edit or print all of them. I'm going to show you another helpful tool that I have now. So here's my light pad. I'm just going to plug in my battery pack, which will light it up really bright. There we go. And then if I bring in my negatives and lay them on top, you'll see that we actually get to chance to have a look at them and decide which ones we like. So this is another way of referencing the print before you print everything up as a full image. It gives you a chance to sort of see what your negatives look like. And I'm just going to show you what it looks like with the medium format as well. So these are our medium format negatives. And again, you can see that they're a larger negative space and that there's fewer of them. But again, it gives you a chance to see the whole roll in one go, rather than individually having to print up every single frame. If you've got any questions about analog photography processes, alternative techniques, if you want to try out a few more things or have any questions, drop me a line. I am on littlevintagephotography.co.uk, and I look forward to hearing from you soon.